Hi everyone. Amazon Cognito User Pools is a service that AWS customers use for managing identity of their customers. It is a fully managed service for all customer identity and access management use cases. Today, Amazon Cognito and AWS Web Application Firewall jointly launched a native integration that brings significant security benefits to Amazon Cognito customers. This allows you to protect identity layer of your applications that use Amazon Cognito from common web exploits, DDoS attacks, unwanted bot traffic, and any other traffic that can consume extensive resources and affect availability of your resources and application. Let's take a look at how this works. You begin by defining Web Access Control List or Web ECL in WAF. This includes one or more security rules that you would like to enforce on your traffic. For example, you can have rate limiting rules to make sure that clients don't send more than a specific number of requests within a few minutes. You can also add deny list or allow list rules. You can also filter traffic based on geographic locations or specific patterns like a combination of headers, user agents, and many other possibilities. You can even write more sophisticated rules that apply to certain application clients or specific API calls in Cognito. This information is available as headers in the request, and you can write rules that target specific flows. You can also use a wide range of managed rules or rules available in the marketplace from AWS security partners. This Web ECL is then associated with a Cognito user pool. When Cognito user pool receives authentication or user management requests from clients, which could be OAuth2 endpoints and the out-of-the-box hosted sign-up and sign-in pages or federation flows, it could also be traffic coming from web or mobile applications using the SDK or direct REST API calls to Cognito user pool. It could also be machine authentications coming from the client credentials flow or backend authentications like things running in a proxy or backend components. When Cognito receives this traffic, it sends sanitized requests to WAF for inspection. And WAF will run requests against the Web ECL that is associated with the user pool and will make a decision. If the decision is to allow the request, Cognito moves on with processing the request. Otherwise, the proper response is returned to the client. It could be a block, it could be a custom response, or it could be CAPTCHA in cases where Cognito controls the UI like OAuth2 flows and the hosted sign-in and sign-up pages. You can enable this feature in two different ways. You can do this from the Amazon Cognito console by going to the user pool properties under the user pool and activating WAF and selecting a Web ECL from there. You can also do this from the AWS WAF console by creating a new Web ECL or editing the associations of an existing Web ECL. And now you will see that Amazon Cognito User Pools is an available resource that you can associate a Web ECL to. Now let's give it a try and see how to configure it and how this works in action. From Amazon Cognito console, you can go to user pool properties under the user pool that you would like to enable WAF on. And now you see that there is an AWS WAF card here. You can edit this card and enable WAF and choose a Web ECL to associate. You can also click on these links to take you to the WAF console so you can create a new Web ECL if you would like to. From the WAF admin console, you begin by creating a Web ECL. Give your Web ECL a name, and from the associated resources here, add a resource and select the Amazon Cognito user pool that you would like to apply this to. Then you start adding security rules to this Web ECL. Just as an example, let's add a rate limiting, choosing rate-based rule and giving a number for the number of the requests that you would like to allow from a single client within 5 minutes. The lowest number is 100. And I will continue until I create this Web ECL. Now, all user management actions that come to this user pool will be inspected against this Web ACL. If I try to access the hosted sign-in pages of this user pool and I send more than 100 requests within 5 minutes, I will be challenged with a CAPTCHA. Let's see this in action. I have already made more than the allowed requests within 5 minutes. So if I try to refresh this page, I will be asked to confirm that I am a human and this is the CAPTCHA response coming from WAF. After solving the puzzle, this is going to succeed, and it will take me back to the hosted UI with a session that is valid for 5 minutes. This is just one scenario, but you can definitely define the rule that applies to your security requirements. And if I try to send API calls to this user pool, the same rule will be enforced. And if I exceed the 100 requests within 5 minutes, I will receive a forbidden exception that this request is blocked due to CAPTCHA from WAF. Because this is an API call and there is no UI that Cognito controls, this exception will be relayed to the application, and it will be up to the application on how to handle this exception. You can start using this feature today, and if you are running workload in production that uses Amazon Cognito, it is highly recommended that you enable WAF to get maximum protection for your applications and resources. Thank you.